Well, reMarkable users, I'm Brandon Bonderfer, creator and founder of the Key to Success Planner. You are looking at a reMarkable tablet as an innovative productivity device that helps you go from a yellow tablet of paper to digital note-taking. Today, guys, I'm gonna show you the Key to Success Planner, how you can go ahead and install it, import it into your device, utilize it by taking all your notes and having a traditional paper-like planning system that you can mark up, you can highlight, you can copy and paste your to-dos from one day to the next, and so much more. With e-ink devices, we have a lot of capabilities to help you become more productive each and every day. And today, guys, I'm gonna run you through a tutorial on how you can do that with reMarkable, showcasing our planner. And if you're not an achiever yet, that's okay. We're gonna show you a set of tools on the device that's gonna help you take better notes and utilize this device for increased productivity. So let's jump right into it and take a look at the planning system on the reMarkable. Well, achievers, welcome to using the Key to Success Planner on the reMarkable. We've assumed at this point that you've already loaded your planner on your reMarkable, but if you haven't done so yet, please go back to our website and follow the installation instructions on how to import your PDF files into the reMarkable. Now, we're going to assume that you put in both a landscape and a portrait version into your planning system. Now, keep in mind, we offer Monday start date and Sunday start date, so in most cases, you're gonna get four files to download. Two being Sunday start date, portrait, and landscape, and two of them being Monday start date, portrait, and landscape. Here we have loaded the executive planner in Monday start date, both portrait and landscape. And I'm gonna walk you through how to get started with our planning system and give you some basic information on how to use it on the reMarkable. First and foremost, if I tap and hold on these files, I have the option to go ahead and tag them, mark as favorite, as well as rename. I can also move them. I have them in a folder called 2024 planners, but I could move them to a different area of our planner. I can also use this to delete them if I installed multiple versions and I want to remove only the primary version I plan to use. But one thing that's helpful is hitting the rename button. And in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come in here and I am going to tap here and I'm going to backspace and just going ahead and remove a few of these words and then hit save. And what that's gonna allow me to do, it's gonna give me a little bit cleaner look at this name on here. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing here. And you can tap ahead of the text if you choose to. You can use the keyboard to type your own text if you'd like to as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit save. Now that you can clearly tell that says 2024 Landscape Monday. I'm gonna open up both of these planners and show you some quick customization that you wanna do to get the best view so that you can use our planning system. First and foremost, let's go to portrait. So I go into portrait planner, you can see this is the planning system. I'm gonna go ahead and swipe just a couple pages past. I can also tap on the hyperlink key and it'll take me to the first key page, which you guys can learn about in our navigation process, and I'll give you a little demo here. First thing I wanna do is I wanna go ahead and set this to view as portrait, and you saw there I changed it over to landscape. The next thing I want to do is I want to adjust the view to height. And what that's going to do is that's going to give me the maximum space of this planner. Now I can go ahead and I can zoom out and I can zoom in, and then I can also use the paper and my finger to navigate. That's probably one thing that's really important for everyone to understand, is that you have to use your finger to navigate. And a couple things that we did this year to make the planning system so much more robust is we added this year at a view. From this year at a view, I can go to any single page in the planning system that I want. So for example, if I wanna go to May 1st, I can go ahead and click on May 1st and it'll go to that page. Now what happens if I wanna get back to that year at a view? I can click on 2024 and it's gonna take me back to this page. Now if I click on key, it's gonna take me to this dashboard. Now if you noticed, if I click on the top side of key, and one thing you guys can do too, you can click on this little circle with the dot in it, and that's gonna minimize that toolbar. But if you click on the top side of the key, it's gonna take you to the left page spread of your key page. Click on the bottom half of it, it's gonna take you to your right half of the page spread. If you click on meetings, it's gonna take you to a page where you have a list of all your meetings. And if you click on projects, it would take you to this page here where you have a list of all your projects. Now, all these numbers are hyperlinked as well. Now, one thing that's really cool about the planning system this year is the speed. We've been able to improve the speed of navigation by over 200%. Almost 250% in some cases. So to give you a live demo of that, we can hit on January, click on one of the dates here, swipe over a couple pages, click on one of the dates here, and navigate. So if you were a previous user of our planning system, that would have took about 30 seconds. You saw that we did that in less than 10 seconds. So that is pretty awesome that we're able to do that this year. And we're able to also improve the pinch to zoom. So now you can almost have a real life pinch to zoom, and you don't have to wait for that screen to refresh as you did in previous years. So that's a big update, and that's even a bigger improvement on our 2024 landscape edition. So let's jump into that one next. I'm gonna expand my toolbar here and hit the X button, and I'm gonna go into the landscape version. Now, similar process, it's gonna start looking like this. I'm gonna swipe over a couple pages, and you're gonna see that the landscape version shows up on our screen. So the first thing I wanna do is I wanna change this right here to set as landscape. And that is going to allow me to turn my device, and now I have it in a landscape format. Now I'm gonna go ahead and choose to adjust view by height again. And that's gonna give me this maximum size. Now I can go ahead and minimize our toolbar, but before we do that, I'm gonna show you just a couple quick things in our toolbar here. Here we have the ability to choose our different pen tools and the thickness as well as a color. You can choose highlighting, and you can choose from here as well. You can also choose the erase tool and how that works. You can also use the backside of your pen to erase as well. And here you have the ability to create a selection tool, which is really beneficial for copying information from one day to the next day. Well, we'll go back to our pen tool. We're gonna choose ballpoint and minimize this. Now that we've set up our view on the planning system, we can access all the navigation tools inside the planning system. All of our professional tools, all of our monthly tools, all of our notes. Now, one thing I want you guys to know across our planning system, I can go ahead and use this information to index a spot. So I could say fishing trip here. And if I go ahead and click on one, it's gonna take me to that designated note page. And up here, I could type in or write in fishing trip. Now, if you're in landscape mode and you wanna have a little bigger space, that improvement to allow us to zoom in is so beneficial for those that want a little bit bigger writing space. You can also turn the device one direction to another and do that as well. But here I could, you know, draw a picture of a lake. This is where the dock is. This is where we're gonna fish. Over here, there's some trees in this area. I'm not the best drawer. But at any time, if I go ahead and click on this key button, it's gonna take me back to that main navigation page. And if I click on the one again, it's gonna take me back to this page, and it resets the view back to the 100% view, and we can easily zoom in again if we choose to. And again, by using that key page, we can get to here. If we click on year, that's gonna give us that full year at a view page where we can access any of the dates. I'm gonna click on May 1st here because I wanna go to May 1st, and that's gonna take us to our May 1st page, and this is our daily page. Also, it's important to know that all of these dates here are hyperlinked. So I can go ahead and swipe one page at a time with my finger, or I can go ahead and click on a designated date and it'll take me right to that page. And again, we can see how that pinch to zoom works by pressing our finger and just pinching outward. We can zoom in a little bit, and therefore that gives us a bigger writing experience. Tom, lunch at coffee shop. And we're gonna meet for an hour. And just for the sake of showing you how that highlighter works, I'm gonna use the highlighter, choose yellow, and I'm just gonna come over here and highlight that time. And that's important to know when it comes to using our planning system, that you have the ability to do that. Again, I can use that select tool, and from here I could go ahead, I could cut it, I could copy it, or I can go ahead and move it. Maybe Tom wants to meet a little bit earlier. So guys, that is a quick look at our planning system. I encourage you to jump on our training. Watch series one and series two. It's really gonna show you how to utilize all the professional tools in our planning system. If you have any questions about our planning system, go ahead and check out our website, jump on chat, and I'm sure you're gonna enjoy what you see in 2024 as we made a lot of great improvements.